Hello and welcome for this video. In this video I will show how you can use a webpack and how you can create your own custom loader. You know the loaders from style loader and the CSS loader and so forth. But sometimes you need to build your own loader and I will show how you simply can do that. So first we need to go to the resource and create the loader. Should we call it loaders? And then we call it custom loader.js. In this file you need to say model.exports is equal to function and then the source. The source is what you get input and we want to return the source to. So between this you can manipulate the input and the output. If you want to cache the file, every time you press save and you don't have any changes, you don't want to run this again, so you want to cache it. That's what we do when we type this cacheable. Of course, if you don't need it, you can just leave it away, and then we want to say what are we doing with we want to make the console log to the source so we can see we load this inside. And now we want to go for this webpack configuration file to load our custom loaders inside. So let's say this one, and then we want the rooms array with this, and what we want is we want to test it on JSON files, and we will exclude the node models folder, and then the loader should be our own loader. And we want to say path object. Normally use path and not path object. It's because I have one ops here. It's called path to a JavaScript library. It's a little bit misleading, but the important here is how it's working. So let's require the path. So we can go down here to the path object. Result, and then the resource loaded custom loaded.js, and the next will be in a JavaScript file here. We want to say require. JSON config JSON file, and should be a config file. Let's say it's a config file. And what we want is say we want to output the console log config, and we want to config output the title. If we go into the config file and say title, and then create the config file JSON. And we have the title, app title here, version 1.101. That's fine for the test, and let's go in for webpack, and we can load it inside here, and it's a crying a little bit. I think it's because I don't do it this way. This, you can see the load inside here. It's what the loader say. Make the console log when you hit a JSON file. This is what we're doing here. And then if we're going for our web page, should be here. Yeah, the version and the title, and we output the title. So this is how you build your own custom loader in Webpack. I hope you enjoy. If you have any question, please make a comment below. I hope you want to like this and add it to your playlist. And of course, I hope you want to share this video to your friends. And to the last, I hope you want to subscribe my channel so you can get more videos from me. And I hope you see you next time.